Greetings, everyone. You are here with Caitlin from Banger Inc. Today, we're going to be talking about how to create accounting reports or financial data for your company, either that's with month-end, quarter-end, or year-end data. So first, let's log into our company. You'll want to have admin rights selected for this, so let me make sure I have that. Yep. For this company, so you can create the correct financial reports that you're wanting. And we're going to navigate to our second item on our menu for accounting reports. Here, you can pull a couple of different reports that are very standard in the software that come with your software straight out of the box. So for this example, we'll just be creating a standard balance sheet for our company. And there's two options that are very standard. You can do the normal balance sheet for the current year, or you can do a comparison for this year and last year's, depending on the period that you're in. So for this example, we'll just pull one of the reports and it'll pull the period that you're in. I have not advanced my period, so I'm going to be in month 4, so April of 2020. Here, the rest of this will pre-populate, but you will also have the option to skip $0 accounts or accounts that don't have a balance in them. You can show the account numbers that are tied to the account names. And then you can also elect to have the values in there round to the nearest dollar. If you don't want any of those options, leave them blank. And then I always hit print preview to view the report prior to printing. Here you can see on this report last year and this year's balances. And then there's also a change column that'll compute the difference between the two columns. The good thing about this report is that when you scroll over a number or you hover over it, if something doesn't look right, you can always drill down into that and see further reports that would explain how it computed that number. So if I wanted to look at this record, it'll take me into the general ledger report for that account number. It'll tell me all of the dates in the transactions for that account and how it came to that conclusion and computed that record number. Once I'm done looking at that, I can always exit out of that and drill down into a new column. This will give you by category, so current asset, current liabilities, WIP accounts, other assets. It'll always give you a subtotal of where you're at for that heading. And then at the very end, it'll give you a grand total, just like your balance sheet will tell you. This is a very standard GAAP accepted balance sheet, or you can always pre-populate your current year balance sheet. If you'd like to schedule this report, hit the button up at the top for the calendar and schedule the date that you'd like. You also have the option to email this, save it as a PDF, export to a Word document, or even export to an Excel worksheet. From there, you can edit the materials a little bit further. If you have any questions on how to create financial reports, please give me a call or email me at coordinator@bangerinc.com. We can dive a little bit deeper into your company's financials data. Thank you for tuning in. If you have any questions, like I said, please feel free to reach out or subscribe to our channel. We will be producing more content related to this in the future. Thanks, folks. Talk soon.